What's going on, everybody? Glad to be back. I'm sorry, it's been a while. I've been super, super busy. I have a lot of really good stuff coming in the future, and I'm really excited that you guys are coming along with me for the ride. So anyway, we got PT Cruiser here, 2002, and it's hot out, and she's blowing even hotter. So this lady came to me. She gave me a little background. She told me last year, you know, it's a 2002, so there is a spec, believe it or not, for an amount of leakage in an air conditioning system. So, you know, you can, I do not know what it is. You know, it could be, it's like a certain amount of gram, maybe even ounces a year, whatever, and probably not ounces, a certain amount of grams a year. So it is very possible that there could just be no refrigerant in the car. It all leaked out through, you know, just some super magic crevice, you know, who knows what. But she told me last year she put some refrigerant in it. It blew cold for a while, but you know, it's back, it's hot. So I'm gonna start it up, I'm gonna show you what we got, and we're gonna just go through the entire process. All right, I'm gonna open up my door so I don't asphyxiate myself, and I'm just gonna show you guys that it is blowing hot. Get my little gauge. We'll start her up. Oh goodness. Get tight. All right. 131,000 on it. I got the AC on max. I feel a little misfire, but anyway, she had a crazy creak that she didn't even mention when I was pulling it in, so we'll take a look at that too for her. But AC is on full blast right now. It's hot. I'm gonna show you the temperature in the shop. It's 75 degrees in the shop right now. No air conditioning. You know, give or take a few degrees, the gauge might be up. Wow, this thing's missing. Anyway, it's probably blowing 85 degrees. A little background about air conditioning. You know, if you don't know what you're doing, you really shouldn't mess with it, because believe it or not, there's a lot of laws, you know, totally legal to vent this to the atmosphere. You know, you could hurt the car if you do this process improperly. You know, you could blow your fingertips off if, you know, you have a, I've heard of, you know, I've never seen it happen, obviously, thank goodness, but I've heard of stories. My old professor told me a story once. I don't even know how, but somebody was introducing it, you know, an extremely high pressure system into an extremely high pressure system. And, you know, what happens is we have explosion through the weakest link. And that would be through probably one of these fittings or wherever you're, you know, somewhere. We're going to have a weak link wherever that's going together. And, you know, it exploded and, you know, the gentleman had no hand in the end or something. But I'm not going to show you my credentials because I don't have to. And you know, bottom line, you know, the homeowner's gauges, you know, they're okay, I guess, if you need to just dump a little bit of refrigerant in there. But be careful, because you're really not getting the whole spectrum. You know, there's just a lot to it. You know, you should never have that gauge on it anyway, because you really should get this system down to a vacuum to begin with. But we're gonna go through all that. Anyway, you're asking me, or you're probably thinking to yourself, you know, these gauges are pretty cool and they do a great job, but, you know, the big machines are definitely better, right? And I have an awesome one right here. Unfortunately, she's a beaut. She really is a beaut, but unfortunately, I've never even seen it work because I bought it used, thinking it was good, and, you know, I bought it in the winter, of course, so I didn't really use it for oh, clearly all went there, and it's got a leak, and I can't figure it out. Something's really out of whack. I put hours and hours into it, and I'm just done. It has a bad, like, solenoid in it. You know, like, it's just some gremlins in there. But anyway, we're going to kick it old school. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. So, anyway, simple, explanation about how any air conditioning system really is the same, but mobile air conditioning, it's really just a big loop, you know. We're kind of just taking a liquid, compressing the living shit out of it, you know, blowing it through a small little orifice, and, we get cold air out of it. It's pretty simple. There are some electronics and stuff, so you kind of need to know your circuits. You know, they're very simple circuits, but it's pretty basic. But anyway, we're gonna go through the entire system. We're gonna make sure it's all good. And anyway, I'll be back in a little while. I'm gonna get it started. Okay, first things first. Let's see if there's anything even in here. And that's by far the easiest service port location I've ever seen in my life. That's great. Let's get these on here. Thicker line, always low side line. Smaller line, high side line. In case you're ever in a real bind. Most guys will put the low side on first. I don't think it really matters. See if there's anything in here. Make sure these are locked. Our hoses are tight. There's no remaining refrigerant in the lines. Let's screw these down. Oh, she's bone dry. She is bone dry. Absolutely nothing. Nothing. Basically, a few ways you could do this. Don't lose these. These actually do hold a very residual amount of refrigerant. These should be on every car that you ship. If not, you're kind of being lazy. A few ways we could do this. Most people will want to bring it down into a vacuum, which is probably the best way to do it to start. I'm no science guy, but I believe, in our atmosphere, like 30 inches of mercury would be a perfect vacuum, absolutely perfect vacuum, but it's almost impossible to achieve that. I think you can do it now with, I'm sure crazy science, but this pump, will bring it down pretty far. It'll bring it down to like, 25, 26, 27. On a small system, I've seen it get down to like 28, 29 inches of mercury, which is pretty damn good for what we need it to do. You could put nitrogen in it and, sniff around. You could put dye in it. You could put a sniffer on it. But for now, we got the vacuum pump. Let's bring it down to a vacuum because I want to show you a technique that I've been using, obviously, since we started doing air conditioning, which is, where to look first. Usually, these, believe it or not, they're pretty good systems. This car is it's a 2002, so 15 years old, Believe it or not, it should be pretty tight. A lot of the times, it's just the valves, there's a little bit of a, whatever the sealant is, whatever the rubber is, it just goes bad, it leaks a little bit. So if we get it down to a vacuum and this thing's holding for, say, a half hour, maybe longer, we don't see the gauge move at all, there's a pretty good chance that the valves are leaking because the valves are encapsulated inside, the cap. This cap is on top of, the adapter. onto this adapter port. And the valve. Ooh, can you guys see that? I'm sorry. And the valve is in there, you see that? So if the valve was leaking, you know, the gauge would never pick it up because it's in the middle. That's the point I'm trying to make.
Got a pump. Fittings are tight, we're locked down. Now we open up both of them. You hear that? The high side gauge only reads positive. The negative. Look at that, sucking it right down. Suck it down for a while. Then we're gonna lock our gauges. We're gonna turn both of these knobs and we're gonna wait. We're gonna go get lunch. We're gonna do whatever we gotta do. We're gonna jump to the next job. We're gonna, you know, be efficient. But we're gonna come back and we're gonna see if that needle moved. We're gonna keep sucking it down. We're gonna try to get that deeper. But I'll be right back. About all we're getting. About just shot 26 inches from up here. Been a while. As you can see, we haven't really moved. Very interesting. So this is what I'm gonna do. I am going to take these off, take the charge, open up the, because I know there's no refrigerant, we're under a vacuum right now. I'm gonna take these fittings off. I'm gonna take the vacuum charge, quote unquote, out of these gauges, and I'm gonna hook them back up, and we should see it. We should see it pin right back, you know, to like 26. And then I'm going to take them off again, just cause I wanna see. I'm gonna take them off again, and I'm gonna, now the valves will be open to the atmosphere. And I'm going to eat my hamburger and come back. And then I'm gonna put the gauges on and see what it reads. And you know, we pretty much have verification that it would need new valves, you know. It's gonna be more of a simple video than I thought, I guess, but at least we have a video. Guys, you don't have to crush these. Guys, while we're waiting, I brought up something really interesting. And I was really interested. I wanted to see the temperature of when the water actually boils. But, you know, a lot of people might be wondering why we would bring the system down into a vacuum. Because besides diagnostic purposes, you know, say you knew you had a leak and you fixed it. And, You know, who needs a vacuum pump? You know, we don't need to bring it down. Moisture is our biggest concern. We're always trying to fight it. That's why we have desiccant bags in line with, you know, the system to take moisture out. You know, that's, we're trying to fight moisture because moisture, you know, one, causes cavitation. Two, you know, it's an inefficient system. So what a vacuum actually does is, you know, going back to what I said before about the perfect vacuum, I brought up this chart and you can see it only goes down to 29.9200, which is pretty damn close to 30, but it's not really 30. But I just wanted to show you why we do this. So water and moisture, believe it or not, boils at a low, as we bring this system down into a vacuum. So it's like one, so it's like our Earth is 14.7 pounds of pressure on us. It's kind of a crazy thing to wrap your head around, but without getting into it, you know, when they manufacture these gauges, like in the factory, so, you know, they put the needle on it, they put the glass on it, you know, they fill it up with whatever, however they manufacture it, it will just automatically read 14.7 pounds of pressure because that's the amount of pressure sitting on the gauge on the table. So they actually go back and calibrate it, you know, back to zero. So now then, you know, we can use the quote unquote zero as, you know, even though it's 14.7, kind of a crazy thing to wrap your head around, but you know, you can buy gauges actually that are, there's a word for it, I don't know what it is, but you can buy gauges that will just read atmospheric. I don't have one, I don't need one, you know, I'm not really a science guy, but anyway, water boils at like 200 and whatever degrees, 212, I guess, right? So yeah, 212 it says right there. And let's see, they started at zero. Okay, so this is, you know, normal, quote unquote. As we go down in vacuum, so you know, 4 inches of mercury is very small. 10 inches of mercury, very small. You know, as we go deeper and deeper and deeper into a vacuum, the boiling point of water lowers and lowers and lowers and lowers. So, you know, if you go up to Colorado and you boil water, it's technically different than Long Island, you know? So if we smash this down into a crazy, crazy vacuum, serious pumps, 29.920, the water's literally boiling at negative 90 degrees Fahrenheit. I mean, it's just a crazy thing to wrap your head around, but that's why we draw these systems down. We need to get the moisture out. So, you know, that's why you need a vacuum pump. That's the way to do it. You know, I mean, change out the desiccant, bring it down to a vacuum. It also helps filling it up because then, you know, the system's down to a vacuum and you go to put your refrigerant in, you start the car. I mean, it just gets sucked right in there and the compressor kicks right on fast. You don't have to jump any switches and all that crazy stuff. Cool chart. That's why we do it. All right, it's been a little bit. Let's see what happens. There's no pressure in our gauges. Let's see where they at. Locked. Yeah. Oh, we got movement. Can you see that? With that, like, negative 20. All right. Let's try to get some air into this thing. Spray some soapy water. You know, we'll be 100% sure. Don't worry about overdoing it here. I mean, the system sees, give it the beans, you know, the system sees a lot of pressure, you're not gonna hurt anything. And you kinda have to time it out. Put it through the low side. What in God's name? Okay. Our diagnosis has taken a complete 180. Complete 180. What does this tell us? Don't trust what the book says. Probably nowhere in the textbook is it going to tell you to put compressed air into the system. It says bring it down into 28 inches of mercury, hold it for 30 minutes, and then if it holds for 30 minutes, you're good. Put refrigerant, ship it off. Well, in this case, we would have been screwed if we did that, because here's my theory. Well, first of all, let's go do this again. This thing's leaking like a sieve. You hear that? It's coming out of the suction line. I thought it was a compressor at first. It's coming out of the suction line. So here's my theory. We pull it all under a vacuum. The lines back, you know, they suck. You know, when we're in a vacuum, you know, the lines are enclosing on themselves. So I'm thinking the rubbers, because look, if I move this, you can actually hear it. I can get it to stop. So my theory is the lines are closing up and it's kind of holding. So yeah, very interesting. It could need valves, probably does need valves, but we have much bigger issues. Through the magic of editing, we will have the part here very soon. And we're gonna pressurize it again, we're gonna test again, and continue on.
Got it. In stock, you lucked out. We gotta go. All the way. Let me go all the way down there.
Now I'm scared if I put my hand down there, I'll never be able to get it out. That's tight. That's real tight. Shit. Uno. Come on. Voila. Make sure the O-rings come out with it. All right, guys, got the new line on. No big deal. Let's try round two. Much better. Much better. Take a listen. Impressive. Take a look at these valves. Look pretty good to me. Look pretty good. Probably get a little more in there. All right, well, what did we learn today? Common sense over the buck. That's what we learned. Yeah, we could have probably put oil in it. Dye in it. And, you know, went that whole route and, you know, put on glasses and took probably like 4 hours trying to find it. We don't have that option today. This lady needs the car back by the end of the day. So we don't have to, we don't have time to be pussyfooting around. We're going to draw it down to a vacuum again. We're going to pull all the moisture out. We are going to charge this bitch up and we're going to ship it. I think we got a job well done. That's the way it rubbed up. Chafing up against the side of the frame rail, actually. Yeah, focus. Yeah. Pretty nuts. You peel it right off. Look at that.